Asking the question, how much does the performer make? How much do they bring to it? How much can they change? What do you think? How big of a difference does it really make?
Maybe.
It makes a really big difference, but I think there's still a kind of central meaning from the song.
Okay. Right? In order to get to the Dionysian, you have to appreciate the Apollonian first. Without that Apollonian background, you can never get to the Dionysian. Is that where we're at, right? You have to have that knowledge, you have to have that understanding, you have to have the background, and then, and only then, can you really, truly get to that emotion?
Well, but I think as you start off with the emotion, like the Marla girl, like when she's a kid, she's painting her emotions, and then as she grows older, she's going to learn, like you said, the genius or whatever, you have to get the genius, you have to break the rules.
Right.
I think you start off there, and then you'll learn all the rules and stuff, and then as you get your knowledge, you learn to appreciate the emotion even more.
Okay, so develop the emotion maybe?
Yeah, like it'll get a deeper emotion from the knowledge that you have obtained.
Wait. I mean, if you understand the path that art has taken, right? I mean, and I was honestly surprised you guys had more of a problem with that one than this one. But the historical development of the importance of painting, right? We went through all those forms that we looked at, right? So all throughout history, the views of beauty, and now we get to this fundamental, like, material aspect of where painting's at. It's about texture. It's about form. And it harkens back to the ancient Greek tradition of art that we started with. I mean, and so if you take it into that context, if you really look at, you know, texture, why okay this one, but not okay this one?
That's boring.
Well, I think that one, if you form your own story, like, if you just look at it, I don't like it. But, like, if you form your own story, like the waiting, it kind of looks like tire tracks. To me, and
okay.
Like, you know, somebody leaving. Like, wait before you leave. Like, let me explain. And so, I mean, now that I look at it again and I thought of it that way when I first saw it, I have a different point of view on it.
Okay. So
for the wait. But, I like it now because it means something to me. But before, I didn't get it.
Okay. So, I mean, basically, everything we've talked about so far in here has been this metaphorical understanding of taste, so to speak, judgment. Tomorrow, we're really going to focus in on literal taste in here. Do you think you can do the same thing with that? Can you change the way you experience something emotionally through increasing your knowledge about it? Does that make sense? Like,
come on, food.
Yeah.
Yes. If it takes a long time to make and it tastes delicious, I will greatly appreciate it.
But more than that,
because like you know, maybe something that's a delicacy in another country, like you go to visit, like maybe if you just ate it and you didn't really know about it, you wouldn't really like it sometimes. But then like you find out like this is a delicacy in this country or whatever, and like kind of like that, you get like the knowledge behind it more. And then people like eat
it. Have you guys ever experienced something like that? Has there ever been something that you really didn't like? And that changed and you do like it now?
I didn't like shrimp for the longest time, and then all of a sudden my mom made me take a bite of a shrimp Alfredo and I was like, oh my gosh, shrimp is delicious. So
okay.
I think more often it works the other way. You like something and you learn about it and then
can you think of an example?
Caviar. When I was little, I loved it.
And then you found out what it was?
Then I found out that it was fish eggs.
I mean, with the Dionysian view, one of the things we struggle with is putting stuff into words. I mean, we talked about that with music today, with the analogy to facial expressions, right? You can't put your finger on it. So how difficult is it to get there and make those evaluations if we're are we missing the tools to do it, do you think? Or have we just not found them yet? Is it something worth trying to keep doing? What do you think about that? How do you get someone, if you agree with this, past the Apollonian to the Dionysian? Because, I mean, that's right, if that's possible, then in theory you should be able to show someone else how to do it, right? If for instance, I get it, shouldn't I be able to show you guys how to get there? How could that happen?
Maybe
it's a
question.
Do you think?
I think you have to teach us the basics and teach us like everything about it, and then we can understand like beyond that.
I think it's something you find on your own.
You give us the tools, but we have to use them, and if we don't, then it's our fault.
I feel so close to you right now, it's a force field. I wear my heart up on my sleeve like a big deal. Your love pours down on me, surround me like a waterfall. And there's no stopping.